not that, for me, not that Pacquiao won, it's how he won. The speed was a lot faster than what I expected. The knockout is something you just didn't expect in such a devastating fashion. It was that alley cat instinct he has about him, and Ricky just couldn't pin him down, ran straight into him.
For me, I just didn't expect the power of Pacquiao at this weight to be that powerful. You know, I expect him to be outspeeding Hatton. I just thought Hatton would take the shots and come on strong late on with the size of him, but he just wore, he was getting caught so cleanly and such devastating effect with every shot.
You warned us, Colin.
Well, ever since this fight was made, I mean, I know it's very easy to sit here and say I told you so, but I told my colleagues who were going to Vegas that Pacquiao will knock him out when he feels like it. Now, the only thing that shocked me was the fact that it happened in the second round. I thought it'd at least take him 6-7 rounds before he did the job. So that's the only reason I'm shocked. I said all along his speed would be too much for Ricky, and that's what did it. And the fact, of course, he went in the ring at 10 stone 8 pounds. He's a powerful man, even though he started out as a light flyweight. He's moved up gradually. He also a very fit guy who lives well. Now, I've also been saying that Ricky Hatton's lifestyle will catch up with him one day. You cannot keep blowing up to 14 stone and getting down to 10 stone or 10 stone 7 without it having an effect on your body.
The danger signs were there from the start, Nicky.
Well, yeah, I mean, right from the very start, every time Hatton lunged in, he was caught with superb counters, great footwork, but terrific accuracy and speed of punch. For Manny Pacquiao.
Look how Pacquiao got the four-shot combination off, up so close, clipping with that right hook. What we constantly saw in training, right hook, roll under Ricky's left. Yeah. Ricky walked into it, rushed into it, doubled the impact,
yeah, just rolled under the shot. It's like watching pad work. You know, you always think pad work is too staged, but that was worked perfectly.
Pad work is how you emulate how the ring work is going to be. Ricky's pad work was against an orthodox fighter. Pacquiao's pad work was against an orthodox fighter in Ricky. Slipped under the shots. They knew exactly what they wanted to do. The finishing punch was the same left hook that put Ricky down when he boxed Mayweather. He drops that right hand just inside the guard because he thinks he's got it covered, got picked right on the button.
I think that's another thing. Ricky just didn't adapt. He didn't change at all. He was hurt in the first round and didn't really learn from it at all.
If you listen to what Moat said...
Well, exactly. I mean, he doesn't...
Moat said what he's saying is he's one-dimensional, right? He fights the same way every time. And all this nonsense about changing his style, I said all along, no, leopards and spots. You can't change after 12 years. Look, and that was devastating.
Such a short left.
And that's what it shocked me. I thought, for heaven's sake, please open your eyes, because that was frightening.
I saw about three jabs from Ricky. The rest of them, they were sort of looping shots. Even that, just when he got picked off there, it wasn't a straight, stiff, high jab. It was a half-cocked jab. He was just about to swing it in, boom. Got caught. Pacquiao knew exactly what he had to do.
But
I know I had to, exactly.
You have to say, I'm, you know, and lots of good judges were wrong about this. You know, I was shocked how big Pacquiao was, how strong he was. But certainly, I didn't think he could punch like that at that weight. You know, Diaz at lightweight took him 9 rounds, and Diaz isn't a great boxer.
Speed creates power.
Oh, it does create power, especially when Hatton's walking on.
Speed kills, they say. Yeah. And well, I shouldn't really say that in view of what of that knockout, but you know. I mean, look, Ricky Hatton's career is over, as far as I'm concerned. He should never go anywhere near a ring again. He's made an absolute fortune, and good luck to him. He deserves the money he's made. There's no point of him going on any further, because there's nowhere for him to go now.
Okay. Do you think there's anywhere for him to go, Johnny?
Ricky, I think Ricky is not that in love with the game to carry on after this. He's tried his best. That was the final achievement that I wanted to do. He's not achieved it. I do believe he'll walk away, but you've got to look at Pacquiao. What a genius at work. How brilliant. Can you imagine him against Mayweather? Now, yes. I love Mayweather to death, but awesome. I think he'd beat Mayweather.
Well, I'm not so sure about that. That's going to be a great fight. I mean, I wouldn't say he's not going to beat Mayweather, but Mayweather is not Ricky Hatton.
No, he's not there.
I understand that, but Mayweather takes a lot of time off.
Mayweather did to Ricky Hatton, but he did it slower because he's not such a...
But Hatton, you know, for all, okay, we're talking on top world pound for pound here, but Hatton's been a brilliant fighter, great entertainer, had a fantastic career, 2 times world champion, can be very proud of what he's done.
What other fighter would take 25,000?
Yeah. So no Vegas. Other fighter, we can't put our finger on any fighter that has achieved what Ricky Hatton's achieved, to travel halfway across the world, to go and watch him, even in a weigh-in. this guy fills more people in a way than I did in a fight. Ricky is a complete entertainer.
Look, don't think I'm knocking Ricky Hatton. I'm not. I'm not knocking him. He's been brilliant for boxing. And if only we had another Ricky Hatton coming hard on his shoulders, which we haven't. You know, Amir Khan probably is our next marquee fighter if he can keep his chin out of the way.
Let's head straight back to Vegas and get final thoughts from Ian and Jim.
Well, one of the most poignant things I've ever seen here after the fight and was a replay of the reaction of Ricky Hatton's fiancée Jennifer. A piercing scream she let out as Hatton was floored so frighteningly, as Colin Hart was saying there. And she was worried, I think, about his very life at that point. Thank goodness, first of all, never mind the boxing analysis, Ricky Hatton is okay and will go home to his little boy Campbell.
Yeah, that is the main thing, but I feel sorry for Ricky because a huge night for him, and I don't think he gave himself a chance to succeed. He came in with the same naive tactics he used against Floyd Mayweather. He had a horrendous opening round when he visited the canvas twice. His head cleared, so you would have thought he'd have come out in the second round with a different plan, back to basics, use his skills, but he came back in the second round, did exactly the same things. He did shake Pacquiao up, which probably gave him a little bit of confidence. I just think he did not give himself a chance with his tactics.
There's a lot of talk, of course, about what Hatton did wrong, but let's pay credit and due homage to Manny Pacquiao. Some people have doubted him. This guy's won world championships in four weights. He's now beaten the top 10 stoner in the world, and he's knocked him out. I think this fella's power just seems to travel up with him right through the weights. He almost defies logic.
Yeah, well, we've seen many great fighters who get better as they come up through the weight divisions. I think it's important, especially today, with the 24-hour weigh-ins, that you're fit, healthy, and strong at the weight. Too many fighters take too much weight off, and it takes something out of their body. Pacquiao, as he's come up through the weights, has got better, he's got stronger, and he's brought his power with him. He's an exceptional fighter.
Yep, that's the final thoughts here from Las Vegas on a sad night, and I do think that really is the end of Ricky Hatton's marquee career.
Thanks to Jim and Ian in Las Vegas. My thanks to our guests this evening as well, Johnny Nelson, Nicky Piper and Colin Hart. There's a chance to see the action again, our final verdict, Ricky Hatton against Manny Pacquiao, Friday, 10 o'clock on Sky Sports 1. And there are replays, of course, at 9, 1 and 7 o'clock today if you want to see the action all over again. Have we seen the final stand of the Hitman? See ya.
Whether it goes the full 12 or whether it goes a few rounds, yeah, it will be a ferocious fight.
Everybody knows Hatton's style. Everybody knows Mayweather's style. Action again.
Non-stop from the first bell to the last bell, and let's see if he can take it.
I'm excited and I can't wait this fight. Let's get it on.
Tic-tac-toe, Pat hit the floor. And you better stay down if you want to be around.
Hey, Manny Pacquiao is not an ordinary southpaw. He throws from different angles, he's hard to read, and he has knockout power.
Whoa, Ricky, I did it! Manny Pacquiao! Yeah.
But the best training camp we've ever had. There can be no excuses for this one, and I'm going to do everyone proud. Pound for pound, number one. That would be something.
I believe I'm going to win the fight. Tonight will be a crowning night.
We had to go out there and fight our fight, and I do feel that Manny will knock him out somewhere along the way.